is up, guys? Eric here from Real Film Reviews, bringing you another movie review, this time for the new David Harborough film, Hellboy. Hellboy is directed by Neil Marshall, stars David Harborough, Ian McShane, and Mila Jovovich. Hellboy is a new retelling of the Hellboy comic about a demon who is brought from the depths of hell onto Earth and is basically adopted and given the job of hunting down paranormal and supernatural entities that are destroying the world and trying to kill people. But specifically in this story, there is a witch from the 5th century who has decided that she wants to kill everyone and everything on the world that isn't some sort of weird paranormal monster, and it is Hellboy's job to bring her down. Now, as many of you know, I do my best to stay away from all reviews before I film a review. However, sometimes a movie gets sort of so either praised or thrashed that it's impossible for me to at least even just miss what it got on like Rotten Tomatoes or something. And yeah, it was pretty well known when I walked into this movie to see it yesterday that I knew I was going into something that was being pretty widely hated in the film community currently. And I have to say, I don't fully understand all of the hate. For starters, I think the cast of this movie is pretty solid. I think given what they had to work with, I enjoyed them for the most part. David Harborough as Hellboy is really, really good. I think he fit the role perfectly. He really embodied the physicality of Hellboy while also sort of embracing sort of his dark humor that he has, since he's doing such horrible things and having to deal with these horrendous monstrosities constantly. But I think he really embodied that well. And then Ian McShane playing his father, I think he also did a very good job playing this guy who is basically having to force his pseudo son into these horrible situations because it's for the good of humanity, because if he doesn't do it, the world could end, or God knows what horrible things could happen. And I really think that those two characters were good, and I'm not really gonna point out anyone else because they're the only two that I think did a very good job. But regardless, there are some shining lights in this movie alongside those two performances. There is the direction. The directing in this movie is decent, specifically given the crazy backstage stuff that has allegedly come out from what was going on the set of this film. This is a pretty well-directed movie. There are problems that I will get to later with the direction, but overall, I was impressed. And I was impressed specifically with the action. The action in this movie is not filmed really bad, and that was what I was expecting going into it. I thought for sure I was gonna get really bad shaky cam and quick cut action that wasn't really gonna show me anything. And instead, this movie actually has some pretty solid takes. One of the action scenes is like a solid maybe minute long, if not a little longer, and it is all one take. Granted, it's a little shaky, but only shaky because they had to utilize some CGI in it, and that's something I'll talk about later. But overall, it was impressive, and I think that most of the action in the movie is that way. It's not super fast cuts or anything like that. They invest in making fun, entertaining action sequences, and I would be lying if I didn't say that I was entertained during those action sequences. It's also kind of funny. Sure, there are some jokes that are bad. They're just flat out not funny jokes. But there are other ones that are genuinely clever and entertaining jokes for the characters that are saying them. And I really think that that's a strength, because I think the fact that they were able to take what seemingly was a horrendous set and a script that was being torn apart while they were filming it and being rewritten constantly, they were still able to put some genuine laughs in this film that I enjoyed, and while watching it, I was actually laughing, and so were the other people in the theater. It wasn't just sort of like a throwaway joke. There was some comedy in this movie that's worthwhile. But now to get to the issues with the movie, and they are just a few really big ones, I would say. For one thing, as I said, I enjoyed the direction of the action and everything, but there was something I had to talk about, and that thing I have to talk about is the CGI. There is an unprecedentedly high amount of bad CGI in this movie. It's not like sci-fi original movie bad, but it's pretty bad CGI at times, and it's very, very prevalent throughout the movie to the point where you kind of can't ignore it at a certain point. It's just there constantly, so much. And there are some really good creature like makeup things as well, and those look awesome, but then I don't know why they didn't do that with so many more things. So much of it is just really, really rough to look at CGI, and I think that they should have tried to move away from it a little more if they could. I understand in some situations you just don't have a choice, but I do think that the CGI in this movie really hurt it, and it even hurt some of the action scenes when there was way too much CGI in them. And then the story of this film is is just all over the place. First off, I want to say Mila Jovovich, I think she did fine. She wasn't necessarily good or bad. I think her role was just exceptionally generic, so there wasn't really that much she could do with it. I think she was okay, though. But overall, this story is just really weird. Cuts away from scenes to other things, it feels so jumbled and all over the place, and it never really holds a consistent tone throughout its scenes, and that was a big issue with it. I really think that the tonal shifts and the random cutaways to different places and different characters hurt it a lot. And then alongside that, I would argue maybe even the bigger issue, is this script is loaded with exposition. Way, way too much exposition. This movie took a script that could have been fairly simple and just given us a little. There's a scene in the beginning that we kind of needed that gave us some exposition if you knew nothing about Hellboy. If you've seen the previous films, you already knew what it was going to show you, but whatever. It gave you that little bit of exposition that you needed to know his sort of past. But then there are just multiple scenes in this movie that go on for minutes, minute-long scenes of just somebody talking about the past or some mythical prophecy or something, and nothing's going on. It's just that person talking, and holy God, is it so boring. It's so clear that it's literally there just to say, the audience needs this information, and we couldn't think of a better way to put it in the movie, so this guy's just gonna stand here and talk for 3 minutes so that way they know what's going on. And then my last issue with the film is actually the blood and gore. So anyone who knows me knows that I'm a big fan of practical effects in movies, physical, real blood squibs and things like that. And this movie does use that a lot in sort of the like scenes where you're walking into the aftermath. But I think my issue with the violence in this film is that while the movie itself is almost doing this over-the-top crazy violence, similar to like an Evil Dead or a Tromaville film like The Toxic Avenger, it's not investing in sort of the more light-hearted aspect of that violence. Those movies are hyper-violent, but they're hyper-violent in a comedic manner. It uses it for dark comedy, where this film doesn't. This film has scenes where there are just numerous people being utterly slaughtered, and we just watch it, and it doesn't serve necessarily a point in the film. Or it does, but it could have been way shorter, and it feels like they're overindulging in the violence and gore just because they were going for the R rating anyways. There is plenty of violence and gore in this movie that works to perfection. It's great. It works really, really well. And then there are really just a couple other sequences that are kind of unnecessarily over the top. This isn't a horror film. This isn't like supposed to be some crazy hyper-violent gory horror movie like a Hostel or something. This is still technically a superhero-esque film, and I think they maybe overindulged a little bit in the violence, especially near the end, and it didn't need to be there. It didn't like bother me to the point where I was like, ugh, this is disgusting and horrible. Like, nah, it's just violence in the movie. It's there for a reason, but the reason is pretty lackluster, and it's more just they want to show people getting killed and crazy ways. And I'm fine with that sometimes, but there isn't enough story or reasoning here for me, and it felt like just because they had the R rating, they decided to just overdo it with some of the violence. I'm gonna give Hellboy a D+. I'm gonna be honest, this movie isn't as bad as I think a lot of people are making it out to be. It is bad, but it's not god-awful. And I think if you have any interest in seeing it, just wait for it to come to Netflix, because it's probably not worth the price of admission. Even though David Harbour is really enjoyable as Hellboy, I think the movie is just pretty lackluster overall. Well guys, as always, I'm Eric. If you enjoyed this video, please do like, subscribe, comment down below what you thought of Hellboy, share everything we do here on Real Film Reviews, and hope to see you guys later.